So here's the results of this mod, the stock hot end with an easily removable 40 watt heater cartridge and an easily removable 3mm screw type thermistor. This is my favourite mod and the first one I'd recommend you do. In fact, it's a perfect one to do while you're building the Rostock kit, since it means you can skip all the messy silicon and it allows easy upgrading to a new hot end at a later time. Alright, to get the mod going, you'll need the stock hot end from SeeMeCNC, a 40 watt heater cartridge, which you can get from eBay, a 3mm threaded thermistor, which you can also get from eBay, that's where I got mine, a 3mm hand tap, and a handle to turn it, which would be jolly helpful, a 2.5mm drill bit, a 3mm grub screw, as well as a JST connector to connect your thermistor into your electronics. Okay, clamp the hot end carefully in the vise in the orientation shown. Remember that this is aluminium and you could crush it if you're not careful. Then you want to grab a nail or a center punch if you've got one and knock a small divot in the center of one side of the hot end. You'll need this divot to stop the drill bit wandering in this convex surface. And now with the 2.5mm drill bit, carefully drill a nice straight hole through the aluminium wall of the hot end. This whole process is a lot easier if you have a drill press. Next, use the hand tap to cut a thread in the hole. Do this slowly, and make sure you reverse the tap out every half or full revolution of the tap to break out the chips. Now you can clamp the hot end as shown with the pre-drilled hole facing upwards. This hole's already the right size, so go ahead and tap this one out. Due to the shallowness of this hole, you'll need to use a second or a bottom tap, which will allow you to cut the threads all the way to the bottom of the hole. Clean up the chips, and then you're ready to assemble. First, take a moment and admire the lovely modified hot end. Then thread the thermistor into its nice warm nest. Install the grub screw for the heater cartridge next, and then install the heater cartridge. And you're all done! I do like to leave the longer leads on the heater cartridge because it lets you connect them into the wiring above the top plate of the printer, which means you have one less connector down near the effector plate. But it's up to you. Well, I hope you found that useful. If you're in Australia, some of the items you can get from my store linked below. Leave a comment if there's something you want me to cover in another video, and I'll see you next time.